deal with airplane peanuts.
What's the captain up, of the ship.
Hi, Bill.
Oh, I don't like standing in between the two of you guys. I feel like you're going to say something, make me hurt my feelings or something.
Thanks for having us on your shitty show.
It's awesome. Oh,
well, they said we want to get some of the shittiest comics we can find. And I said I could get you 2 for 1.
Good hit, Bill.
That's good. Congrats. I love your show, F is for Family. Dave has a show coming out called S is for Scurvy.
Dave, why are you wearing a children's bathrobe?
Nice one, Bill.
This is really fun.
I love it, because, you know, I always wonder what the Blue Man Group would look like when they weren't wearing the makeup. And it's just good to see.
Today is Monday, June 6th, and Bill Burr just dropped a brand new Netflix special. Kinda. And one of the cooler ways of recent to promote other comedians, Bill Burr teamed up with Netflix to present Friends Who Kill. Essentially, it's a showcase on Netflix hosted by Bill Burr featuring 10 of his funniest friends in comedy. Welcome back to the Joke World Comedy Update, where every Monday we're bringing you the breaking news in the comedy world, whether it be new specials, actual breaking news, where people are at on tour, and even who was on each other's podcast last week to make sure that you don't miss anything. Make sure you subscribe to Joke World so you don't miss the comedy update, and you can also download this episode on Spotify, wherever you listen to podcasts, to make sure that you can listen on the go and you don't miss anything. You're in the comedy loop. The only channel doing this, guys. What else do you want from me?
You look like that guy they interview on the news, and this guy was here to see it. Can you tell us what happened, sir?
So it's called Friends Who Kill, and it comes out on Netflix today. It's an hour and 13 minutes long, and it starts off with a 10-minute set from Bill Burr before he brings up his first friend, and then he hosts the rest of the show. The friends range from stars and icons like Jimmy Carr, Jeff Ross, Dave Attell, who a lot of people say is the GOAT. Then you also have like Ian Edwards on there, Jessica Kirsten, Josh Adam Myers is on there, who I saw in Austin live a few months ago, and I think he's one of the funniest people on earth. Definitely recommend checking him out. Netflix tagged this as raunchy, which we know probably means good. So definitely check out Friends Who Kill on Netflix. Comes out today. Bill Burr, new special, and he's promoting great comedy, which is really cool.
Nice to see you wear your clean jacket for this TV taping.
Bill, and I can never thank you enough for letting me live in your car. I really,
Dave's dressed for Wednesday and Thursday.
Thank you.
George Carlin just had a new documentary come out a few weeks ago. It originally aired on May 20th on HBO. It's a miniseries out right now. You can still watch it. Directed by Judd Apatow, so it should be very good. I have not checked it out yet, but this is what Kelly Carlin, George's daughter, has to say about the documentary. She said, "Having been the public keeper of my dad's legacy these last 12 years, I've dreamt of the right people appearing at the right moment to give this documentary telling of my father's story what it deserves. An honoring of his comedic genius and unique cultural impact while not shying away from his personal struggles and humanity." So check this out right now if you have HBO, George Carlin documentary. I mean, he's one of the greatest comedians of all time, definitely on the Mount Rushmore, super influential to everyone doing it today. George Carlin documentary called The American Dream, out right now on HBO. There's been a lot of comments on the original video we did recapping the Tiger Belly versus Brendan Schaub drama, asking if Brendan Schaub ever actually showed the proof to the Tiger Belly team that they were behind the Reddit harassment. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you can go watch the original video right now, or save yourself some time because this seems to all be in the past. But basically, Brendan Schaub accused the Tiger Belly team of being behind the years and years of harassment that he's received online, specifically on Reddit, and that he had a bunch of proof and screenshots and papers and this ongoing investigation of allegations against them, and that he can prove that Tiger Belly's email address and URL and whatever was behind all this Reddit harassment. They were fueling all the hate that he gets. So this is a clip of Tiger Belly talking about what Brendan actually showed them after that show.
"We have not seen said 300 pages of documents. After the podcast, we were shown a couple of zoomed in screenshots of source code with no context. Our email address is in the corner of one screenshot and the name Robert Lee on the corner of another screenshot. When we asked him who sent these to him, he said Brian. We then asked to be connected to his team directly to get further clarity, and he assured us that he would make that happen. We followed up with him for the next 3 days, and finally on Thursday, we received a text from Brendan saying his team would prefer to handle this issue in-house and does not feel comfortable sharing information with Tiger Belly. To recap, we have not received any substantial evidence regarding the accusations. We have not been in contact with a team. All we've seen are some screenshots sent to Brendan from Brian Callen. We're hoping to get some closure on this, but that's probably not gonna happen.
I also came across a few clips of Kalilah discussing past open relationships that she's been in and like how she's broken up with guys in the past, and it all kind of ties into this current situation with Bobby in a weird way. And it just blows my mind that she's saying this stuff on a podcast, or even if it was in private. Like, I just can't imagine my girlfriend saying anything like this. I think if I heard her say this, especially if it was on my own podcast going out to the world, I would either instantly kill her or kill myself. And I don't think that's a hot take. Just watch these clips, dude, and tell me that I'm wrong.
Can I just be really, like, candid with everybody? This is going to be the first time I ever say it, and he'll never admit to it, but Bobby's a cuck. I think that he fantasizes about other dudes being with me, and he gets off on it, and he'll never admit to it. But the reason he talks about it is because he secretly loves it, and he, even if they don't hit on me, he wants to believe they did because it gets his dick hard.
This road of love, this story that we create, doesn't have to be defined by such strict rules of monogamy.
Whoa, dude, what are you saying right now?
What I'm saying is I would never I would never betray your trust. I would never do anything without you seeing it in broad daylight. What I'm saying is, down this road, should you ever come up to me and say, hey, you know what, sweetie, this is what I had in mind, and this is what, you know, whatever we need to do to spruce up our sex life.
Nope. I will not allow.
Why are you so...
Because this is exactly the road you went down with G-Unit and Steve.
No, I never... That was the first... you're going to hold me to one relationship.
No, I'm saying, no, I'm not holding you to it, but I'm saying that these are the seeds that are being planted for that kind of situation. And what I'm saying is that I'm not going to do that.
What I'm saying is, yes, I do. Maybe I'm projecting my own fantasies.
Like, I brought in somebody in a relationship towards the end.
Wow. Wait, with him there?
Yeah.
Whoa.
You brought him back to the house?
Yeah.
And he knew who that other guy was?
Yeah, like I was in a relationship with two guys towards the end.
What?
What do you guys think? Comment if you would like your girl talking like that in public on a huge podcast. Comment, yes, I would love that, or no, what the fuck?
Real quick, I gotta mention the sponsor of this video, eWin Gaming Chairs. If you're looking for a new gaming chair, this has gotta be the brand for you. Supports up to 550 pounds, so it doesn't matter if you're super fat. They got these big pillows for your neck and your back. Adjustable armrests, they go up and down and they wing left and right. This is the best chair I've ever sat on, the best item I've ever sat on in my life. You cannot sit on anything better than this. It reclines all the way back like a car seat. Wanna give you the full extension here, up and down. I'm not even strong enough to get it all the way down. This is an elite chair. If you're looking for a new gaming chair, if you're a gamer, or if you're someone who just sits a lot at your desk, this is the chair to get. eWin Gaming Chair, link in the description right now for a great deal on one of these beast chairs.
The guest list is where we go through who was on each other's podcast last week to make sure that you guys don't miss any episodes that you'd want to watch. So we're going to start off with Theo Von in this past weekend. He had on Sal Vulcano last week. Hilarious episode. I think that is a must watch, if I do say so myself. Sal was also on Whiskey Ginger, so it's a great week for Sal fans. A lot of good content out there.
The first book I ever read in my life was Green Eggs and Ham.
Was it?
I swear.
Mine was... Nobody Listens to Andrew, a book I still own. My mother got it
for real?
Yes.
I thought you were going to be like, mine was the Iliad. You know.
Mine was Mein Kampf, and I got to tell you, tough read. But I got through it. I was young, but I got through it.
Joe Rogan had three episodes last week. He had Fahim Anwar, who has a new special coming out, Kristen Beck, and then some MMA episode. I can't pronounce this guy's first name, but his last name is Sterling. Tiger Belly had on Chelsea Lynn. Your Mom's House did not have a guest. And then Kill Tony Tonight features Derek Poston. Three specials out right now that I think are definitely worth the watch would be Stavros. He came out with a brand new one today, actually, live at the Lodge Room. A lot of people super excited about that, or actually might have been last night, but it's brand new. And then you got Mike Cannon, White Privilege Homeless, that came out a few weeks ago. And then Fahim Anwar, The Hat Trick, live at the Comedy Store. He was on Rogan promoting it. It's at the Comedy Store, and he goes in every single room and does a special put together. It's very cool. Those three are all on YouTube. And then obviously the Bill Burr Friends Who Kill is on Netflix. This has been episode 2 of the Comedy Update, the Joke World Comedy Update, making sure that you're in the loop with everything happening in the comedy world. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again next Monday. Make sure you subscribe to Joke World right now. Tell your friends about the update if they love comedy, and go follow us on Instagram, where you can get these free Joke World stickers sent to you, or these ones are free. Doesn't matter. We'll send you both. I don't care. They're free. Just go do it. Follow us on Instagram. DM us. Hey, I want those free stickers, man. And you'll get them in the mail. You'll be so happy. And people will stop making fun of you for not having Joke World stickers.